you are still have some influence on the UN and the latest UN resolution India passed against the gay rights. Your interest on the Mahabharata, where we have respect on Brahmanala and we have sympathy toward Amba. Do you think that this is more a right-wing, this thing that we don't want to accept a gender rights and then we want to be prejudiced towards a particular gender?
I'm so glad you pointed out that the authentic tradition of ancient India and of Hinduism is actually one of broad acceptance and tolerance. That there has been very little that was prohibited or that was condemned or that was judged that harshly. And certainly, as you point out, in the Mahabharata, there are transvestites and people who would not fit into conventionally acceptable definitions of gender, who are accepted as characters and personalities in their own right. But we went through, of course, various historical experiences, including Victorian morality. And much of our legislation against homosexuals and so on goes back to the British days. And I believe the rather feeble defense being offered by the government for voting along with the Russians in this unsuccessful, fortunately, attempt to be homophobic at the United Nations. The feeble excuse offered by the government is that since it is illegal in India, because you remember the decriminalization of Section 377 by the Delhi High Court was struck down by the Supreme Court on the grounds that it was not the place of the court to make this decision. Parliament had to pass a law. And this government has so far not been prepared to bring a law to decriminalize homosexuality. And therefore, 377 is still on the books and homosexuality is still illegal. Therefore, says the government, we had to vote with the Russians against homosexual benefits. But in fact, the option of abstaining was always available. We could have said, you know, we have no difficulty with giving the Secretary General the right to treat his homosexual staff the same way he treats his heterosexual staff. But because our law doesn't recognize it, we will not vote in defense of it, but we will not vote against it either. We will simply abstain. That could have been an option, but they never chose that option. They chose instead to arraign themselves with a minority of intolerant regimes. And I think it was a great disgrace for the Indian people that the government was allowed to do that.